Now, before we get into today's episode, I want you to be sure and subscribe to our newsletter. There is a link below to it in the description. That way we can stay connected no matter what happens, even if the fit hits the shan, because we got a country to save. You can't make this up. The playwright who conceived Hamilton, who made Hamilton a white founding father, a black man, is being hammered by the left for failing to cast a more diverse cast in his new movie. I cannot make this up. And now he's apologized. Here's what he said. I started writing The Heights because I didn't feel seen. He didn't feel seen? And over the past 20 years, all I wanted was for us, all of us, to feel seen. All he wanted to do was feel seen. I'm seeing the discussion around Afro-Latino representation in our film this weekend, and it is clear that many in our dark-skinned Afro-Latino community don't feel sufficiently represented within it, particularly among the leading roles. Here's the part where I inform you that blacks have higher self-esteem than whites and much higher self-esteem than Asians, despite not seeing themselves in roles on TV, but I digress. Back to his apology. I can hear the hurt and frustration over colorism, a feeling still unseen in the feedback. Colorism? Is that like racism, except with color? I hear that without sufficient dark-skinned Afro-Latino representation, the work feels extractive of the community we wanted so much to represent with pride and joy. Extractive? Sounds painful. In trying to paint a mosaic of the community, we fell short. I'm truly sorry. We fell short.
Just a bit outside.
And I'm truly sorry. I'm learning from the feedback. I thank you for raising it, and I'm listening. I'm trying to hold space for both the incredible pride in the movie we made and be accountable for our shortcomings. He's trying, really, really trying. Thank you for your honest feedback. I promise to do better in my future projects, and I am dedicated to the learning and evolving we all have to do to make sure we are honoring our diverse and vibrant community. Siempre, LMM. End of quote. Goodness, even Bill Maher says, enough with the apologies.
There's Latinx performers, one black lead, but no Afro-Latinx. The committee that makes note of everyone's skin tone discovered this, and then Lin-Manuel Miranda had to say, I'm truly sorry, I'm learning from the feedback, I thank you for raising it, and I'm listening. I promise to do better in my future projects. This is what I was talking about with Nikki. Please stop the apologizing. You're the guy who made the founding fathers black and Hispanic. I don't think you have to apologize to Twitter. For f***'s sake. This is why people hate Democrats. It's cringy.
This is Rich coming from a guy who used a race card to slam then President Bush for his alleged slow response to Katrina and New Orleans. He said the reason Bush didn't care about New Orleans is because it was French, black, and sexy. He also slammed Sarah Palin with, I thought, the worst word you could call a woman, the C word in his stand-up. He called Michelle Bachmann and Sarah Palin, quote, two dumb bimbos, close quote. He even referred to Sarah Palin's son with Down syndrome, Trigg, as retarded. Bill Maher is smart enough to know his butt is next. And that's why he's pushing back against this cancel culture. Indeed, MSNBC had a few things to say about it.